to STG Kids Online. My name is Laura Grace, and I am so excited that you're here with us today. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome! We're so happy to have you here. Miss Kate and I can't wait to share some incredible stories with you from the Bible. Every week, we have a big picture question to help us remember what we are trying to learn from our Bible story. Do you remember what our big picture question is this week? That's right! Our question is, how did God plan to fix what sin broke? The answer? Before he created the world, God planned to send the Messiah to save sinners. Before we learn about our Bible story today, let's stand up and sing a song together. Do you remember why we sing songs of praise to God? That's right, because he is loving, merciful, patient, and good.
I know the plans I have for you. This is the Lord's declaration. Plans for your well-being, not for disaster. To give you a future and a hope. To give you a future and a hope. I know the plans I have for you.
Friends, and welcome to STG Kids Online. I am so glad that you are here with me today. I wish you could be here in person with me at St. George's, but thank you so much for joining us online. I just want to take a few minutes to think about ways in which old things have been replaced by new things. Can you think of anything old that has been replaced? What about something like this? Do you know what that is? Have any of you ever used one of these? This is an old telephone, and I actually remember using one of these at my grandpa's house. Pretty cool, huh? So what has it been replaced with? What do our phones look like now? Right, something like this, probably. And let's try one more thing. Okay, do you know what this is? Any ideas? This is a cassette tape player, and I actually had one of these when I was little, and I was very excited about it. So you could listen to music or books on, and they're called books on tape, okay? What do you use to listen to music with now? Maybe Alexa, or your computer, or a phone, the radio, yeah? Does anyone still use a CD player? Yeah, some of you? Yeah, so all of these things, technology has changed so much over the years, and then keep upgrading and getting newer and better things, right? Things that usually make our lives easier. And today we are going to learn about a time when God promised to upgrade his people to a new covenant. And covenant means agreement or promise, right? God made a promise with his people. And our Bible story today is from the book of Jeremiah. And Jeremiah is a name of the prophet in our story, okay? Are you ready to see and hear it? All right, let's begin.
When Josiah was the king of Judah, God called a priest named Jeremiah to be a prophet. God told Jeremiah, "I knew you before I made you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I chose you to do very special things. I chose you to be a prophet to the nations." "Oh no, God," Jeremiah said. "I don't know how to speak in front of other people. I am just a boy, only a youth." "Don't say that," God replied. "You will go where I send you and say what I tell you to say. I am with you. I will protect you."
For many years, Jeremiah spoke God's message to the people of Judah. He reminded them that God had made a covenant with them. If they obeyed him, he would bless them. But the people did not obey. Now God had to punish their sin. God said the people would lose their land, their wealth, and their freedom.
Jeremiah explained that people's hearts fool them into thinking they are better than they actually are. They trick people into wanting things or doing things that God does not want for them. The people did not want to listen to Jeremiah, and Jeremiah was sad. He warned them that God's punishment was coming, but he also said that God had a plan to change his people's hearts. God promised a new and better covenant so the people could be saved from their sins. God would write his law on people's hearts. He would give his people power to obey his commands. God said, "I will forgive their wrongdoing and never again remember their sin."
God told Jeremiah to write God's message on a scroll. So Jeremiah spoke God's words, and his friend Baruch wrote the words on a scroll. Baruch read from the scroll so that all the people heard God's words. He warned that the king of Babylon would come and destroy Judah.
King Jehoiakim sent one of his officials to get the scroll. As the official read the scroll, King Jehoiakim cut off each part of the scroll and threw it into the fire. He did this until the entire scroll was burned up. So God told Jeremiah to write another scroll with the same words as the first scroll. Jeremiah told the king, "God is going to punish you, your family, and your leaders for doing wrong things. God warned you this disaster will come to Judah. You did not listen."
Jeremiah told about a day when God would forgive sin and change people's hearts. Jesus made these words come true. God forgives our sin through his Son, Jesus. He changes us and gives us power through his Spirit to obey his commands.
All right, so the promise or covenant that God made with Israel meant that God would bless them as long as they obeyed him. So if they did not, he would punish their sin. And even though God's rules were clear, the people did not listen to him or obey the law. So they chose to sin and sin, and God kept showing them mercy and giving them warnings and lots of chances to repent and to say they were sorry and to follow him, but they still disobeyed. And Jeremiah told the people to expect punishment, but Jeremiah also offered the people hope. Jeremiah told God's people about a new and better covenant or agreement or promise. In the old covenant, the people obeyed God to gain blessings, but in the new covenant, God would pour out blessings so that people could obey. Instead of having the law on scrolls, God would put the law on their hearts. God would even give them the power they needed to be able to obey. And the new covenant would be amazing, much better than the old one. And do you know why? Do you know how that is possible? That's right, through Jesus. And what's even better is that because of Jesus, that new covenant is here already. Okay? He lived a perfect life with no sin. Then Jesus died on the cross for our sin and rose again on the third day to defeat death. And after, Jesus went back to heaven, and he sent the Holy Spirit, who lives in believers, to help us love and obey God. That means that God knew we would choose to disobey him, and yet he still chose to create us, and he gives us the freedom to make choices, and he sent Jesus to rescue us when we sin. And it just makes me think, well, what an amazing, good, and loving God he is. All right, so let's take a minute now to pray and thank God for loving us so much.
Let us pray. God, you are so good and you are holy. We know that we do not always love you the way we should. Help us see the bad things we do and say sorry to you and others. Help us love you more and obey you each day.
Thank you for our church family and the opportunity to be together online. Please be with all of those who are sick, lonely, or hurting. Please bring them healing, comfort, hope, and peace. Amen.
God really is so good, and he loves us so much. Does anyone know what time it is now? It is time for our memory verse. That's right. And we are still in our memory verse that we've had for the past few weeks. I don't know if you remember where it's from, but it's 2 Chronicles 7:14. So that's 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14. And it is, if my people who bear my name humble themselves, pray and seek my face, and turn from their evil ways, then I will hear from heaven, forgive their sin, and heal their land. Okay, and we have been singing a song to help us remember that. So if you want to, you're welcome to stand up and to sing it with me now. All right.
If my people who bear my name humble themselves, pray and seek my face.
Before we go, I thought you might like to do a craft with us, okay? And you can do it with us after you see the video if you want, and it's gonna end up looking something like this, okay? So if you want to, go ahead and watch right now for this week's craft.
Hi friends, and welcome to our craft for November 8th. We're so excited to have you here as we examine God's laws and how they look in our heart. And so you can see our guiding Bible verse today is from Jeremiah 31. It's verse 33. It says, "I will put my law within them and I will write it on their hearts." And we can see God's law being portrayed through our hearts through joy, faithfulness, gentleness, goodness, kindness, self-control, patience, peace, and love. These are also known as the fruits of the Spirit. Okay, so the materials you're going to need for this craft are your handout and string from in your bag. You're going to need scissors and glue also. Okay, to start out, you're going to disattach the string from the back of your piece of paper. Next, you're going to cut out the hearts. Okay, Adelna has all of her hearts cut out, but don't worry, you can pause this video if it's taking you longer. Okay, so the next step is to take your string and disattach it from the sticker. You're going to have two long pieces and one short piece. You're going to attach them all to the white heart. You're going to attach the short string in the middle and the two longer strings on the two sides. Awesome. Okay, now you're going to arrange your hearts on the strings. You can do this in whatever pattern or whatever order you want. You should let your glue dry for about 10 minutes. If your still isn't holding together, then you could always try using tape. This is Adele's final product. Yours might look a little different, and that's totally okay. Feel free to hang yours in your room, in your locker, in your cubby, anywhere that it will remind you how God's laws and commandments look lived out in daily life. Remember that God loves you very much and always listens when you pray. I can't wait to see you next week. Thank you for joining us.
Hi again, everyone. I'm so glad you were able to join us this week. Remember, if you want to do a craft from our story about Jeremiah, you can ask a grown-up to grab a pack from the church office for you to have at home and to do right after we're done. We hope you have a wonderful, safe week. And remember, you are so loved. Bye.